To address the public outcry, Midgley held a press conference, and there he poured tetraethyl lead onto his hands, and he inhaled it for a full minute. He claimed he could do this daily without harm. But Midgley knew the dangers. The reason he had turned down the public talks was because he spent much of 1923 in Florida, where he himself was recovering from lead poisoning. He didn't go anywhere near his company's product if he could help it.
Lead is dangerous even in small doses. It mimics calcium in our bodies, so there's no efficient way to get rid of it. And like calcium, lead can be stored in bones for years, meaning it can continue to poison the body long after the initial exposure. The organ most sensitive to lead is the brain. Lead breaks down the myelin sheath around axons and prevents the release of neurotransmitters. That's why common symptoms of lead poisoning are headaches, memory loss, and tingling in the hands and feet. And children are particularly susceptible. Lead exposure can cause permanent learning disorders and behavioral problems. And the dangers of lead had been known for hundreds of years. Already in 1786, Benjamin Franklin